What's up? I have bikes parked outside. It's sunny day in Finland. Last time I just talked about the bikes. This time I think I'm gonna do something with the bikes. Especially the front brakes on the Kawasaki. It feels a little bit weird. I don't know why. Please wind, stop. But I must check the brakes. Then I try to put the front light on the Honda and more wind. And I also have this on my hand because of that. You can see that this is bended. My weldings have cracked. So I crashed because I used to drive with the Kawasaki. And now with the Honda I pushed the front brake a little too much. Front end locked down and bike went sideways. I think the Kawasaki's crash gates would not take more than one hit. This is the first that gonna hit the ground. There's no any support. This is way too near to the frame. I have to build new crash gates for the Kawasaki. When I bought the Honda, it was crashed on this side. So that's why the rear brake pedal is bended. I think I'm gonna change new pads for the rear. Oh, I almost dropped my cell phone on the asphalt. Luckily it went on the grass because my cover is right here, it's not on. So luck this time. As you can see, sun is shining, but I think I'm gonna move the bikes inside because there's so much wind. Yes, I think I'm gonna take the Kawasaki first and check the front brakes. The bike is inside. Now, let's figure out why this is so weird. You can hear. It's not supposed to do that. I think I'm gonna bleed the brakes first. Then I move to the next part if it's not working. Brakes are now bleeded. There was a little bit of air. I don't know if that was the case, but I go outside and test the bike and see what it feels like. I noticed that I have to change the fork seals also. I changed those on winter, but I don't know what went wrong, but it's leaking again. So, fork seals on winter. Let's see how the brakes feel now. Brakes feel much better now. Kawasaki feels good now. I think next is the Honda's turn. I'm gonna mount the front light because if I don't have light, the police will pull me over soon. And then if I have time, I change the rear brake pads. I got the Honda inside, and so this is my light. I got this from eBay. It was like 20 bucks. Quality is 20 bucks, so I had to do some changes to it, but now it's good. I have good light in this, and I'm gonna mount it like this. I opened the light and there was this bulb inside. This is 35 watts. I got lucky. I managed to get this H1 bulb inside. It's 55 watts and now I have good light in this eBay thing. And I did order new levers from eBay. I think those were 20 bucks. And new clip-ons and bars also. I think those were 20 bucks also. Also. Many alsos. I had these lying around and I checked with these aluminium things I made that this is the right distance between the holes. Now I can make the brackets from this easily. Now the light is on and I can say it looks pretty good to me. Nothing too special, but fits to the bike. Let's take the bike outside. Focus. I have to shorten this a little bit, so it's grinding time. I have to take the seat and the tank off, so I can get the wiring. That is the next thing I have to do. Everything is finished, and now when I turn the key, light is very bright. And bike starts great. I'm gonna put the bikes inside. Until the next time.